Hi guys, today I will put MedFusion Pro head-to-head with built-in Unity solutions like static batching, GPU instancing and SRP batching. I will not compare the systems in aspects for which they weren't designed for. For example, I won't judge static batching on how good it deals with dynamic objects. Likewise, I won't evaluate the systems based on the convenience for developers in controlling and adjusting the combining process. Instead, we will compare them on a simple static scene with a simple static objects and try to fight them on their own ground. The scene we are going to test on is just a bunch of objects piled up in one pile. I took them from the free assets, I will leave the link in the description. The scene contains 6,634 regular game objects, 54 lot groups, 12 unique materials that use the 3 unique shaders. These are standard, standard specular and transparent diffuse. You can see the computer specification on the screen. Let's run the scene with static batching and GPU instancing, turn it off. Let's take a look at the scene statistics and remember these values as a reference ones. To ensure that no optimization is being applied, we will open the frame debugger. Great, now let's enable static batching and observe the improvements it brings. This is very easy to do, just mark objects as static. The number of batches has decreased significantly, but the number of setpath calls has increased significantly too. FPS is almost unchanged. Let's make sure that static batching is applied to the scene. Next, let's disable static batching and enable GPU instancing instead. This process is also simple, just activate the enable GPU instancing flag on the all materials. Now let's run the scene. We will notice a significant decrease in both the number of batches and setpath calls. Additionally, the FPS has increased by 10 frames, which is pretty good result. Let's verify that GPU instancing is indeed working correctly. I will now apply MedFusion Pro. I will demonstrate how to do this in future videos, as the asset is still under development. For now, let's leave it as a bit of mystery. By the way, although MedFusion Pro is not compatible with static batching, it can quite well work with GPU instancing. So, if you have a choice between MedFusion and GPU instancing, you can safely use both. However, to the sake of purity of the experiment, I disable GPU instancing. Firstly, there has been a significant reduction in the number of batches and setpath calls, resulting in a notable increase in FPS. We can notice that the number of vertices has slightly increased. This is because the size of the meshes has increased when they have been merged. In Unity, even if a small part of the object gets into the frame, then the object will be fully rendered. However, it's important to note that MedFusion Pro minimizes this effect, as evidenced by the performance gains achieved in our scene. Now let's make a comparison with SRP Batcher. I created a new Universal Render Pipeline asset and upgrade the materials. Let's run the scene and see the results. As we can see, the number of batches and setpath calls has decreased, and FPS has increased. Let's make sure that SRP Batcher really works. Now, let's compare these results with MedFusion Pro. By the way, MedFusion Pro is also compatible with the SRP Batcher, but as previously I disabled it. As before, the difference is significant. That's all for today, I hope you enjoyed the video, subscribe to my YouTube channel and follow Unity Forum for updates. Feel free to share your suggestions and ask any questions you may have. Goodbye.